this video, I'm going to introduce you to the Kokoni EC2 3D printer. The Kokoni EC2 has a build volume of 100 by 100 by 60 millimeters. It's small, but mighty. It's perfectly sized for small toys, props, or other little things that you may need to make. As I mentioned earlier, I've enjoyed using it immensely for printing props for my smart dolls. Check out all these tiny little things that I have made for the dolls that I fully intend to paint. It can print up to 100 millimeters per second. Technically not super fast, but fast enough to get things done without having to sit there and wonder if you're going to age out of this machine. Given its form factor, it's highly portable. And because it's fully enclosed, I would even say that this is a great entry-level machine to give to a kid. Of course, with safety supervision. Of course, I'm not giving this to my child. This is for me and my inner child so that I can make props and things for my smart dolls. There's also a camera inside so that you can pair with the app and actually watch your work being done and check on progress without having to sit here and babysit it. Setup was pretty easy. Inside the box came the Kokoni EC2, a power adapter, some tweezers, and then a small bag that included two or three pieces of painter's tape that are blue, I'll get to that in a hot second, as well as a filament clamp and, of course, the manual. So if we remove the build plate, which of course is metal and super high quality, and we turn it around and we look, that's where I've stuck that painter's tape. So the point of this tape isn't necessarily to help with stickiness or anything like that. And neither is the glue if you want to smear the top part of your build plate with it. The point is actually to provide a little bit more lift so that it can make contact with the nozzle and the filament that's coming out of the nozzle. And I don't know what it is about it. It's magic. But I did have some bed adhesion issues at the very beginning, and it was solved basically by putting this little sheet of tape down here. And then I'm just gonna slide this right back in place like that and close the door. Kokoni's app is actually pretty comprehensive considering it's a beginner application paired with a beginning machine. They offer a rich library of models that you can pull down and use on your own. They provide a lot of them, but there are other users in the Kokoni system that have actually provided models for other people to print as well. All you have to do is browse through the application and do some searching, find the model you want, and hit start. Now, of course, some of you are probably wondering, can I use my own models? The answer is yes. You can use Kokoni's service to upload your own models, and it's cloud storage tied to your account that you can access from your phone. Then you can select your object and bring it in, make all the necessary adjustments, and print from there. Now, I did mention that it's as simple as selecting a model and then saying start, but there are a few options that you have available to you in the app if you feel like you need to tweak it. So you can move, you can rotate, and you can scale the model however you like. I will note, though, that if you do any kind of scaling downward, then you may want to be a little careful as to how far down you scale that model, because if you have something that's got walls, they're going to be thinner the smaller you make that scale. For example, here's a vase that I printed at 50%. The walls were so thin at that scale that there are areas where the filament didn't stick, causing gaps between the layers. I printed it a second time at 100% with normal precision, which looked a lot better than when it was scaled down. Of course, the application also provides you with the option to give it supports. You don't actually apply the supports, though. It's done automatically by the application, and sometimes these supports can be a little thick, so you're going to want to have some kind of tool to clip or snip away those supports carefully in some of the more dense areas where they contact the model. I will say that Kokoni is actively working on adding tree supports as an option, so you can use normal supports or the new tree supports. As far as the timeline goes, not entirely sure on that, but I do know it's coming and I'm looking forward to it. The other option that they give you in the app before you actually say go print the thing is what kind of precision you want it to be at. Kokoni offers low, normal, and high precision options. Low is ideal if you just want to kind of test the model, print it out, see what it looks like, and also something if perhaps it doesn't have a whole lot of detail on it. Normal is just going to be an average print. It'll take slightly longer than the low quality, but it will show more details. Then you have high precision, which is going to take a lot longer to do, but it's perfect if you have text, really small details on the model that you want reflected in the final print. Note that those precision options that are available to you in the application are not reflected by having to change out nozzles or anything. They're just going to change your layer height. While you're printing, you're gonna wanna have this somewhere stable and safe. You don't want it in any place where a cat is gonna knock it over, ask me how I know, or a child is just gonna go, whee! If the print messes up and you have to stop everything, you can't resume from where you were, which is fine because most machines are like that anyway. Here's a time lapse of when I went to print out the Lotus Bowl for one of my smart dolls. The machine was really quiet while operating. All I could really hear was the fan going and sometimes the head move if it needed to move very quickly, but otherwise it was a really fluid process. When it's done printing, open the door and remove the build plate. Gently flex the build plate on either side to pop the print free, then scrape the plate clean because you don't want to leave the little filament rings on the bottom as they'll interfere with your next print. So let's talk about the filament. So I am used to a machine that has exposed filament rolls that's like hanging out everywhere, kind of like some of the ones that I've reviewed in the past. So with the Kokoni EC2, since it's basically a fully enclosed system, you need to use the app to swap out the filament. But a lot of people are gonna wonder, like, can I use my own filament? Well, first, yes, you can, but the EC2 is specifically designed to work with their filaments to get the right results. So it kind of depends on how much frustration you want to lay at your feet, especially if you give this to your child. So the filament is actually in this back case here, and it's looped around in there. And all you need to do to change it out is to basically unscrew this and to unlock the back and remove it and then refill it. And of course, that is going to be driven by the app itself. There's a QR code that you can scan. On their website, they offer a ton of different color options that will specifically fit the machine, and you can easily install them, again, using the app. Now, swapping out their filament from one of these cases for your filament is basically just winding it into this box and then feeding it through. However, you have to tell the app you're using their stuff. Now, this is kind of a choose your own adventure risk-taking experiment. Their machine and their firmware is specifically tuned for their filament. It bears repeating because if you put somebody else's branded filament in there, like insert brand name here, then who's to say if it's going to clog up the nozzle or not? There's a lot of different properties that go into filament printing, the heat of the nozzle, how the layers are going to look, et cetera, et cetera. So if you do choose to do something silly, like crack open the case and wind your own filament into it, you're on your own. That said, I do think it's important to call out that it is a possibility because the last thing you want to do is to have this machine become a brick if for some reason you're incapable of buying more filament that fits the machine. Should you find yourself stuck and need help, you can go to the Kokoni website to use their live chat bot to troubleshoot or file a ticket with their support team. And now that I've gone over all of the features and basically how to use the machine, let's look at some of the results. Here we have the bowl that was from the earlier time-lapse footage printed at low precision. It looks really good for having been printed at a lower quality. A little bit of sanding and filler is gonna make this real easy to paint. Then, of course, I wanted to test an articulated model as those are pretty neat for kids to make. This required no supports and printed in under an hour at normal quality. Apart from some sticky parts in the hip joint, I barely had to do any cleanup. I later printed a croissant and some sushi. All I did for these was prime and paint. I printed with normal precision. I could have sanded it a bit, but it was too exciting to get them painted. I also popped in a Fusion 360 to make a tray to hold the food because of course I did. And you can't just go printing and painting miniature food items without setting up a party for your smart dolls. Oh, this? Yeah, that's a Nintendo Switch. I painted it glossy black and glued on a screenshot of Metroid Prime Remastered. I don't have a problem. I can quit making miniature props for my dolls anytime I want. Thank you so much for paying attention. Feel free to like the video, subscribe to the channel, and look down in the description below to learn more about where you can get a Kokoni EC2 or locate more information on it. See ya.